Hi, this is Chef Mick from Tony's Market. Welcome to my kitchen. Shrimp is a very special food indeed. It's incredibly popular. This is a $50 billion business with some 8 million pounds harvested annually. With that much shrimp on the market, there's a lot to watch out for. Irresponsible practices cause massive environmental damage every year, and then most shrimp are treated with a host of chemicals to improve the flavor and to soak up more water weight. Our job at Tony's is to find the very best tasting and cleanest shrimp possible from the most earth-friendly sources and at fair prices. By contrast, most retailers only consider price, and when it comes to cheap shrimp and cheap product, it's the earth that gets stuck with the tab. At Tony's, we take quality and responsible practices very seriously. Today, let's focus on a few of the very best shrimp from around the world in a handful of recipes that I know you're going to love. Selection will vary throughout the year, but I picked out a few of what I think are the very best species of shrimp that are almost always available. These are Mexican white shrimp, a firm and meaty wild shrimp that also does well in aquaculture. It's the classic shrimp for cocktail in most recipes. These are Argentinian red shrimp, a deep water shrimp with a buttery yet snappy texture and a lobster-like sweetness. This is an amazing shrimp that cooks quickly and is proving to be sustainable. Next, Mexican rock shrimp. Once the rock hard shell comes off, they aren't much to look at, but trust me, these have a very special taste and texture. Relatively unknown, ordering in advance is suggested. These 4 to 6 per pound tiger shrimp are huge. Meaty and satisfying, I like them in the pan or on the grill, and they make a big impression next to a steak. And finally, our ever-popular hand-cooked shrimp. These are white Mexican shrimp cooked to perfection in-house and the ultimate in shrimp cocktail. Cleaning and deveining. If not already done, just split them down the back, wash out the vein, and peel. These pre-split or easy-peel shrimp are very handy. I like cooking them shell-on. The shell adds flavor to the dish and keeps the shrimp moisture, especially when grilling or simmering in sauce, and then it's easy to peel while eating. Peeling is simple. Just slip the shrimp out of his jacket. Be gentle and either leave the last tail joint attached or carefully pull it apart, pinch the very end of the tail with your fingernails, and tug to rescue that tasty bit of tail fin meat. Now let's turn these red shrimp into ceviche. Mexican white or rock shrimp would also work really well. Start by cutting peeled and deveined shrimp into small bite-sized pieces. Ceviche is traditionally cooked in lime juice, which does kill quite a bit of bacteria, but I've been in food service too long and feel better blanching them first to kill all surface bacteria. Just about 60 to 90 seconds in boiling salted water, it didn't even get back to a boil, then shock chill. Pour a half cup of lime juice over a pound of shrimp and then marinate for 15 minutes, no more, no less. Then combine about 3/4 cups each of tomato, cucumber, and red onion, 1 to 2 jalapenos, and 1/4 to 1/2 cup of cilantro. Toss the veggies in another 1/2 cup of lime juice and season to taste with salt and pepper. I also added a cubed avocado since it'll be served immediately. Other seafood or veggies can be added, and even mango is nice in here. Serve immediately. This dish is best served a la minute with Tony's chips, guacamole, salsa, and hot sauce. Now a quick pan dish to serve as an appetizer or as a main dish over pasta, risotto, or polenta. Heat about 1/3 to 1/2 cup of good olive oil, add 4 sliced garlic cloves, and when blonde, add crushed red pepper and 1 pound of rock shrimp, or your favorite shrimp. Saute for about a minute and then toss in 2 teaspoons of paprika, and when combined, add a small glass of sherry, vermouth, or white wine. Season with salt, pepper, and a squeeze of lemon, and finally, finish with some fresh parsley. I served this over thin spaghetti with vodka sauce, and it was truly divine. I like the shrimp piled on top rather than tossed into the pasta. This would also be great with marinara sauce, basil pesto, or a cream sauce. I think Mexican white shrimp makes the ultimate shrimp cocktail. I start with lots of salted water, seasoned with shrimp and crab oil. Add the shrimp and cook for about 1 minute. It might not even come back to a boil. Then I remove from the heat for about 1 minute. Times will vary depending on your shrimp, batch size, and even your altitude. Personal taste prevails and practice makes perfect. I like short cooking time for the juiciest shrimp, but when you're the chef, it's your call. Immediately move to a bowl of ice to quickly stop cooking and splash with plenty of fresh lemon juice and a glass of white wine. Once cool, it's ready to serve. I also prefer Mexican white shrimp for frying. Peel and devein the shrimp and slide it onto the ends of thin skewers, but keep the tip of the skewer inside the shrimp or it gets stuck after cooking. I gently bend and hold the shrimp nice and straight and secure it with the skewer, trying to make it perfectly straight just like they do in Japan. After all, we're making Japanese ebi furai, or shrimp fry, borrowing a word from English. Run your skewered shrimp down the breading line, dust in seasoned flour, dip it in a beaten egg with a little water to thin, and finally roll generously in panko breadcrumbs. Heat your oil to 360 degrees and take a moment to think about safety. Hot oil packs a world of hurt, so be mindful. Keep the shrimp as cold as possible and add the skewers one at a time, taking care not to overload, hence dropping the oil temperature. Cook until nice and brown and drain. Ideally, these should be done immediately before serving, but if you need to do this ahead, chill and warm the fried shrimp in the 375 convection oven. I think Tony's cocktail sauce is the ultimate with boiled or fried shrimp, but here's a simple secret sauce recipe that's great with a lot more than shrimp. 1/2 cup Japanese QP mayonnaise, it's amazing stuff with an extra high yolk ratio. 2 tablespoons of ketchup, I like the Sir Kensington's the best. 2 to 3 teaspoons of sugar, 3/4 teaspoon each of garlic powder and paprika, 1/4 teaspoon each of cayenne and salt, and 1/2 teaspoon of sriracha. Feel free to adjust everything to taste. This sauce is great with everything from hamburgers to hot dogs and sandwiches, dip in chicken fingers or veggies, and of course, seafood. Now for a simple shrimp remoulade for making a fried shrimp po' boy with our ebi ferai, or as a shrimp and vegetable salad. Just toss our homemade remoulade with some cold cooked shrimp. Our hand cooked shrimp is the ultimate of what I used here. Serve this on a toasted bun, over greens, or just in a bowl as an appetizer. It is so fast and easy. Now let's get after those massive tiger shrimp. I have 3 peeled and 3 in the shell. I'm going to marinate for 30 to 40 minutes in our sweet chili ginger marinade, but teriyaki or Santa Maria would also be nice. I think shell on shrimp turn out the best on the grill, but without the shell, I like to wrap in bacon. Tuck in any extra meat and just do your best to wrap them up. I haven't discovered any special tricks, just work to get them fairly tight, as straight as you can so that they're easy to brown on all sides, and secured on both ends. 2 skewers may help hold the bacon better. You'll need to watch these closely on the grill. Brown all sides over medium-high heat, and then to finish, brush them with more of the marinade and move to indirect heat or into the oven. The sauce glazes nicely, but can burn quickly. I take mine off the heat at about 140 degrees internal. The leftover marinade can also be used as a sauce. Just warm it first for safety. These monsters are stunning and always a show stealer. Serve 1 or 2 of these next to a steak and you'll have a friend for life. Shrimp seasons fluctuate throughout the year, so species, sources, and sizes will vary. But we're always shopping for clean, earth-friendly shrimp of exceptional taste and quality for all our families. Here are my secrets for success. Always buy the best quality shrimp possible, responsibly sourced, and without brines or additives. Keep shrimp in the refrigerator until time to cook and plan ahead. It cooks really fast. For grilled shrimp, consider leaving the shell on and marinating before cooking. And if you like that snappy, crispy texture, soak in our classic brine for about 20 minutes before cooking. Keep your preparation simple and don't overcook so the shrimp's natural taste and texture can shine through. And if you don't see what you want when you're shopping at Tony's, just ask. Check to see what we have in the back. We're truly lucky to have the world's finest seafood and meats at our fingertips 365 days a year. We really should be grateful. I know that I am. I'm Chef Mick Rosacci. I thank you for shopping in our markets, and I thank you for joining me in my kitchen.